Hey everyone, welcome back. We are going to do something a little bit fun and use DALL-E to generate two app designs for us. And we're going to try and rebuild that in SwiftUI. Let's do it. All right, so now I've already done a banking app. I think this time I'm going to try fitness, right? So we'll go fitness app UI. Okay, so I can't imagine there being too many UIs in the data set for DALL-E. So if this is something that you recognize, please let me know in the comments. But for now, I think we're going to go with, like, I really like both of these. I kind of like all of them in a way. They're not great, but I mean, they actually look a lot better than some of the stuff I've received from humans. So let's go with trying to replicate this one. Yep. All right, so new Xcode project. We're gonna go with app and SwiftUI. And I'm gonna set up the Git repository because I will make this accessible to everyone once this video is finished. Okay, so this first screen looks like it might be some kind of a log of some sort. This is gonna be very difficult to decipher. Okay, let's get started with at least the top red section. So we've got our VStack, and what we'll do is create another VStack inside here. Because we can see that these are stacked vertically. And let's find an appropriate icon. It looks like it might be a user profile or eye. So I think I'm gonna go with person.fill. So we go system name. After a while, you do tend to memorize these SF symbols. Now we can set the size by using the frame or the font. So one of the benefits of setting it to font is that it will reflect the user's settings across their entire device. I think in this case, since it's like in the header, we probably want to have a fixed size for it. So we're going to go with frame. Generally, you would use the font if you were putting the symbol next to some text. Let's just go 50. And we'll make it resizable. Past workout results. Let's go with that for now. And then underneath that, we have some more text. Okay, now we're going to set the background to this pinkish reddish color. Custom color. And we will use the color picker. Just like that. And there we go. Perfect. Underneath this, it looks like we have a button. So let's add the button. Looks like a button to me. I don't know what it does. Let's change the foreground color to white. Let's do that with all these. Entire VStack. So all the contents gets changed to white in one go. Now it looks like under here we also have these could be a segmented control. I'm gonna go with that. I think that might be kind of cool to have in that. These could be like the tabs. It also looks like down the bottom here we have a tabular of some kind, but I think I'm going to ignore that and we'll just go with what we can see up here. Kind of look uppercase to me, so that's what I'm going to go with. All right, now the trick to make this red box area expand to fit the whole screen is to set up fixed size. It's to set up the frame. And we want to set the max width to infinity. Better get rid of that padding. And this is starting to come together a little bit, right? It looks okay. I think I'm going to increase the frame here of that text. I really want it to be on two lines. Yeah, I think that's fine. And I'm going to go through and replace these now that we're working with iOS 16. In fact, I think what we can do is maybe set it up to bold across the whole view hierarchy. Looks like it works. Cool. All right. Next thing is this segmented control across the bottom, which I think in SwiftUI is a picker. Actually, I'm going to treat these as separate buttons. I think that actually makes more sense in this context. So yeah, I've changed my mind about this. And that's okay. So what I'm going to do here is a HStack. Because to me, it kind of looks like these are different button selections. Maybe this is kind of like a header. And then there's some buttons over here. These could be edit buttons like on that you usually get on a table view. So let's just go with that. And I think I'll just go with text for now because we're not really building an app. Okay, so here's an interesting situation. We've got this unbalanced H stack. And what we want to do is have it balanced so that the middle item is sitting in the middle. How can we do that reliably, right? So we've got two views on the far left. We've got a view in the middle, and then we've got a view at the far right. And it's these two views at the far left that are kind of messing things up for us. So we need to restructure this H stack so that the middle item actually sits in the middle and the other views work around it. A quick and dirty way of doing that is to use a Z stack. So what we can do is start with a background Z stack. Dump all this stuff in there. We'll take this out and just leave the space behind. Inside here, we'll wrap these in a H stack. And then we'll have another H stack. And in here, we will put our original middle section. Just throw these in here. And there we go. We've got the middle item in the middle. So let's add some padding around that. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so let's work on this next section. So down here, we'll have another V stack. Get rid of the default content. And let's take a look at, we could add in, we're going to need to create some rows, I think. So I'm just going to create another view for that. Okay, so far so good. This row view will have a HStack. Okay, so here we've got our list with a single row in there. What we might do is change it to a different style and see what we get on the other side. Preview. I think plain might be the one we have to go for, just so that we can adhere to the design specifications. Now, row view requires system image to be specified. So let's add that in there. And for this one, I'm going to go with a picture of this person drowning. that's good. All right, so it also looks like we got some headers or buttons at the top of this list, so let's just chuck those in real quick.